board.
Whoa! Good morning.
I was going to do something for the shark tooth.
What were you going to do?
I don't know. Just last minute, I decided to just go deep. Good morning.
You felt like that was that goes with it?
No, but just decided last minute to go deep. I don't know why.
All right.
I got a little creamer in my drink.
We have
today
good coffee this morning.
Yeah.
Makes a difference.
So, set the alarm for 5 this morning, but woke up, I don't remember what time, generator kicked off, which I knew that was going to happen, and then, because we were just letting it charge the battery bank up as high as it can go, and it got to 100, and then woke up. It's like, all right, it's a lot. So I got up and I switched the power to power the house off of the solar battery bank. Mm-hmm. And then about 3 o'clock this morning, and that completely died. I think it was 11. We fell asleep pretty early. I think it was 11 p.m. Woke up, switched it over. From 11 p.m. to 3 a.m., it drained that entire thing. Because it's so hot, the AC won't kick off, it can't keep up, it's so hot, it drained that entire battery bank, 2 battery banks.
Yeah.
In a matter of, what is that, 5 hours?
It's kind of,
Or 4 hours, I guess.
Yeah, I don't know, that, it's kind of a bummer a little bit.
It is, it's just, but it was 96 degrees yesterday, felt like 106.
It is. Get to the point where it is way too hot.
Yeah.
If you guys remember me last summer, I was like, I can handle all the things.
Yeah.
But then when it gets to this point with the heat.
I can handle the heat, but you can't.
Man.
Yeah.
Not one of us can. And it does make a difference that we have a pool.
Yes.
Huge difference.
Yes. But it does make a big difference when your partner says, "Do you mind turning the generator on?" And I go out there and it's not freezing. That was the worst in the winter when it would run out and we'd be like, "Oh, I hate this." Because then you got to get fully dressed, layered up, go out there, fill it up.
Yeah, you would have to do that in the morning to make coffee.
Well, yeah, but it's cold.
Yeah.
But for me to go out and I'm just in my underwear.
Yeah.
That's a big difference.
Yeah. Yeah, because we have that big sleeping bag, so generator cut off in the winter, in the middle of the night, we were good.
Yeah, but it's still cold when I had to get up and get that generator going.
It's like even whenever you get out of the sleeping bag.
Yeah.
So I would just stay cuddled up.
Yeah, you would.
Thank you.
I stay cuddled up in my fitted sheet this morning. She only gives me one sheet to sleep with.
Why do you always say
that? And it's fitted, and so I just like wrap it over my head.
No, we have wolf blanket, and then the
everyone knows the wolf blanket's yours, so you're calling yourself out.
And then the just the normal bedding, but I always bring clean sheets and stuff to swap out. We just hadn't swapped it out, and you grabbed it.
Actually, I think it's an extra. Maybe. Yeah, it's an extra because I made the bed.
Mm-hmm.
And it's an extra, and so I just thought one time you were like, "Do you need the blanket?" And I said no, and then you were asleep and you had it, and I just said, "I'm gonna grab this sheet," and I put it on, and you made fun of me for having the fitted sheet.
Well, at least he was all wrapped up.
Well, because I wrapped it around my feet and then up and then over my shoulders, and it held perfect, and I said, "This is actually genius." So now when I sleep and it does not super cold, just use that.
Yeah. So it gets all wrapped up.
It works perfect. It's actually genius. You can make fun of me all you want, but you haven't tried it yet.
I'm not making fun. I'm just I think it's cute.
Well,
I like that you do. It's not making fun.
I like my fitted sheet.
Yeah.
But yeah. So yesterday, I know y'all get mad. Why even bring it up? Well, yesterday we hired someone to bring something out here so we can get some stuff done. And we learned some stuff about our property that him and his dad used to come out here all the time.
Was dad used to work?
Yes. So we'll leave that at that. But we're getting more details about it and about stuff out here. Yeah, she...
We'll make sure Stella's not chasing the...
She was looking a little bit. But we're finding out the real history of this property. And I'm pumped.
Mm-hmm. It's not what we thought.
Yeah, we learned a few things from neighbors and stuff. But we're finding out the true stuff. And it's pretty cool. I don't want to say anything right now just because we might get it wrong or might get some new information.
We're going to get some more info.
Yeah, today probably.
So, I don't know, we're pretty excited about
it. So, we'll be talking about that in a video pretty soon. It's very interesting. Not what we expected. Mm-hmm. Some of it what we expected. Some of it definitely not what we expected. And this is first-hand information from someone that actually was here and utilized. So,
it's pretty crazy. What I think is cool is almost like everybody out in this area, this town, is used to come to this property.
Yeah, that's also bad.
Something of the lay of the land.
Yeah.
But I think it's like, it's a part of everybody's like growing up. I used to go hunting there all the time. Like,
we hear that from every neighbor.
Everybody.
We would go down to the river and go through y'all's place, or we would ride four wheelers or hunt turkey and deer.
I grew up
camp
hunting.
And all sorts of stuff. And
so I don't know. I just feel like it does like add a little bit of magic to this place.
Yeah. I mean, it is cool that a lot of people know. And what's crazy is the guy that we hired, so he's not actually from this town. So the fact that a lot of people know, wake up, whoa. A lot of people know about it. So when it's all said and done and we got everything good and it's all the fencing set up, house, barminium, studio, I mean, the shop, like everything. And then if people end up coming out here for whatever reason, they're like, wow, I used to come hunt out here. Y'all have done a lot, because they would know when there was nothing. Mm-hmm. So that's a cool thing, that if someone comes out here and sees what we've done and know what it used to look like, that's pretty cool.
Yeah. I mean, about it.
Yeah. You try not to cuss, is that what happened?
Yeah.
Maybe we adults.
I was going to say something else, but this fly keeps distracting me.
Yeah. But yeah, we'll have a busy day today.
Brandon's not here.
Yeah.
Another one. We ran off.
He came up and...
We ran him off. Just said,
He said, definitely got the days wrong. I don't know why we woke up and was like, today's the day Brandon's coming up.
Well, the day before, too, we were thinking.
Like, I know when he talked to me, he said, not this weekend, next weekend. And I don't know if I just said something to you and we started talking about it, and then we just, in our brains, it was just like, that's this weekend. I don't know. But, so Brandon's not actually here this weekend. Ran him off, and another one boss does. But it'll be next weekend.
Yeah.
So which
that's going to be our B.
Which actually works out great, because kind of what we're doing here today, this weekend and stuff, Brandon's
going
to
love it.
Yeah, he'll be pumped and all of that. Started
from the bottom, and now we're here.
I don't know. And then it started from the bottom, but I don't know the rest.
The whole team's here.
Oh, yeah, well, but they're not. We ran them off.
I know.
But we started cleaning up some yesterday, and we were like, all right, gotta get that camper cleaned out. Brandon's coming. get it all done up, and then so I was just like, all right, it gives us a little more time to really get in there, clean it how we want, all that stuff. And yesterday ended up being, not that it wouldn't have been a good day if Brandon was coming, but since we were like, oh wow, we're really not in that much of a rush as what we thought, we had a little breakfast in town since we were in town picking up some stuff.
Country platter.
Yeah, we went to a little local cafe, which you actually thought of a really good idea for a video. And I don't know if it'd be a Crocker Life video or a Crocker video or what, but we want to do like a tour of the town of things you should do if you're visiting Bristow.
Because we know we did a tour.
Yeah. But that was kind of like, what's in this town? We're just
yeah,
we're
new
here.
Yeah, but not like, all right, this is what, if you're trying to live like the Crockers.
Yeah.
So it's like, yeah, stop at the
Crocker
cafe.
The Crocker experience in Bristow.
Yeah, stop at the cafe, the open door at the Junos.
Yeah.
Go ahead and just stop by there.
You know that's how the Junos found out about us, right? It's because of the Bristow
oh,
radio.
Oh, yeah.
And I was at Walmart. That's She's true. Like, I just saw you on YouTube. I said, oh, no. But,
and then Chrissy was like, get this cow. Mm-hmm. And then.
And just happened to be from them. It was wild.
Yeah.
Definitely small world. Yeah, I don't know. Yesterday ended up being pretty chill. We ended up, you know, going to town, getting stuff we need, all that. You know, messed with the animals, did, you know, little things, cleaned a little bit, did this and that. Got in the pool for a little bit, did some stuff around the pool.
We got the pool situated again.
Yeah.
We're not really, okay. Pool filter. Yes.
We gotta go look at it today. Okay. It was looking good yesterday.
Yeah, but the pool filter is a sand filter, and it puts out sand.
But we didn't buy just sand, we bought sand balls. It's like little, looks like cotton balls, but it's got sand in it, and that's all there was on Amazon. And we don't know if, I don't know.
Yeah, we don't.
I've never had a pool filter like this.
Yeah, I don't know. There's things we're trying to figure out. Pool filter and solar.
Yeah.
So.
We're figuring it out.
We're figuring it out.
And getting that all done up and whatnots. And yeah. And it's just one of them days. We got some work to do, but you guys will just be seeing on a Crocker video. We may go live tonight. May try to put a video out today. I don't know. We'll see what happens. But worst case scenario, if we don't post anything today, the video will be coming out Monday. I know we've been a little bit hit or miss on posting videos and at what time, and it's just been very sporadic and not very organized. We've been taking care of ourselves and taking care of things around here and not focusing too much on the YouTube side of things. Really
just kind of figuring it all out.
Yeah, really just working on everything. And now that we got a good game plan, we got it all figured out, we got little things we need and needed and all that, and it's about to be rock and roll, Tom. Yeah. I'll just say that. I know we kind of hinted on it in the last video, said y'all guys are going to love what we got planned. And I think that's the truth.
Everything from out here. We're also family planning. We can say that.
Hmm?
We're family planning.
Hmm?
You don't know that? Like, when we're going to have a baby.
But we tell them that?
No, I'm saying we're family planning.
When are we having a baby?
We're just trying to get everything. I don't know. The whole plan of it all.
Great. I was just being like, baby?
I knew what you were doing.
I mean, literally, when I say figuring things out, we're figuring things out. Everything in our life, just all of it.
Yeah.
Again, I think we talked about it in yesterday's, but we just had like a really good talk, really dove deep on things that we want, things like priority list of those things, just everything like that.
would be like a timeline.
Yeah.
All that type of stuff. So.
Yeah. So it has been a little, again, sporadic with posting videos and kind of keeping y'all not in the loop of things we're doing and all that, but it's literally about to change, and I know we're excited. I'm sure once we start really putting it out there to you guys can be very excited, and sometimes you just have to step back a little bit, not worry about, you know, especially like for us, don't worry about putting out overly polished video about this and that, and thinking we need to do a certain thing. You know, a lot of you guys said, just do what you need to do, figure it out. We'll still be here, you know, like, post what you need to, when you need to, take a break, whatever. And,
yeah, it's kind of like we were able to, I don't know, we get very caught up in our own responsibilities, which is a lot, obviously, out here, and then you throw in the job on it, and then my job, just like everything, just caught up in responsibilities to where you sometimes you have to like really take a step back, think. I don't know, that's what we've been doing for the last little bit.
Yeah.
I think we got it figured out.
Yeah, I definitely think we do, and again, I think you guys are going to be extremely pumped, all of that. We are, like, a lot of people, this is why it doesn't bother me when people say it. You never finish anything. You never follow through. You never whatever. No. We have a very different way of doing things, and it's like, just look behind us. The podcast table. We have that done up. We have stuff ready to go for it. We're right there.
Yeah.
The shop, it's right there. The studio, it's right there. The tiny house, it's right there. The animal stuff, it's right there. So what we've been doing is, we've just been working on it, going around, and instead of one thing, work on it, be done. One thing, work on it, be done. One thing, work on it, be done. You work on it, work on it, work on it, and then boom, they're all done at the same time. And
boom.
It works for us, it just doesn't look good on video.
Yeah,
because,
and I understand as like a viewer,
yeah,
it could be hard to follow, and that's why we're not for everybody, and that's why the people that are here, we appreciate you.
Yeah.
Like, I get it, I do get it, we get it.
Yeah.
But it's,
we just do things differently.
It's who we are.
And
it's like on the Crocker family, I posted this video of like a household of like, an ADD wife or whatever.
Oh, I didn't watch that. I saw you posting it.
Oh, and it's spot, just the first little bit spot on, talking about projects. It's like, she'll go in, start a project, next thing you know, she's over here, over there, and there's a million projects that are like halfway done all around. I'm like, yes.
Yeah. Our brains can't handle a big project start to finish. Mm-hmm. I guess I personally can't do it. There's no way. My brain just thinks about 100 other things, and I would rather work on 100 things at one time and get them done at the same time than work on one, get it done, work on one, get it done, work on one, get done. But it's all coming together right now at the same time.
Is it doing this?
Well,
but it's not going like that.
Well, you made a collage.
That's coming together.
Yeah, but ours is like,
but then that never comes together.
Yeah.
At the end. Oh, then it falls apart. Then it comes back together. Mm-hmm. And it falls apart.
And then it's not running in parallel. It's that
congruent.
It's congruent. You were watching solar video.
I was
yeah, just put it lightly. I wasn't gonna tell him. Baby. All my personal information does not need to be out there like that. My pooping, okay? Don't do that. If you'll know, you'll know. I was pooping, and heard you playing the video. I was like, what? And then I started hearing like parallel and this and that.
I'm trying to figure out the solar.
Yeah.
It's very confusing.
So we got connectors and whatnot. It's just, we don't know the right way to...
This is not our world.
No, not at all.
And even,
we'll figure it out.
Yeah, we're going to figure it out. Looking online and everything, it's like I have to only do little bits at a time and come back. This is just, it's confusing to me.
Yeah.
And normally, I can look stuff up. If I research, I can look stuff up, got it. And I'm like halfway there. Not a full expert, but halfway expert on all the facts.
It's better to be a jack of all trades.
So, jackass?
Than a master of one. As the whole thing goes.
I don't know.
It's better to be a jack of all trades rather than a master of one, because
master of none
is better than a master of one. I don't know the ending of it. Y'all know what I'm talking about. It's too early.
Yeah, but I don't know. This stuff is, I don't know, it's kind of hard for my brain to grasp. So it's kind of,
but we'll figure
it's
it
humbling
out.
Me a little bit. I'm not used to that, so.
You're not used to not knowing everything? Is that what you just said?
Not used to, like, whenever I look something up, not really, like, understanding it.
Yeah.
But it's just, it's almost like, I don't know, it just does not make sense to me whatsoever. But I'm going to figure it out.
Yeah, electrical's a weird thing.
It is very weird. I don't.
You can have the exact same thing. It just depends on how you run your wires, just how much power you're going to get, how many volts, how many watts, how many whatever.
I don't like it.
I would have thought it would just plug it in and it's going to pull something down.
No.
That's not the way it works. But.
And we've tried different settings, different, I don't know. But we're going to, and Stella's going to come in.
This city dog.
Stella.
She is just a spoiled little inside city dog. She's loving it.
Oh.
But you can just tell the difference. Yeah. We'll bring him in.
Here she comes. You guys want to meet Stella?
We'll bring him in.
Stella.
And then all the dogs will be laying down, and then she'll be in a chair.
Can you say hi?
And of course, Lucy's just super jealous. All right, we're going to knock this over.
Oh, whoa, whoa. Stella, say hi.
I know looking at her, you couldn't tell she a city dog.
Turn around. There's Stella.
All right, guys. It's going to be a little wild in here. All right.
All right.
We're going to get you on the next one.